That kind of social tiering that goes on that's in horse racing.
Oh, very much so.
I mean, it's. I suppose you could stand on the outside and knock till you're blue in the face. You
right.
don't have any knuckles left. There is just, you can race horses, but there's also another a big hurdle to jump, and that's getting into the social.
That's right. It's a very,
scene.
Very tight, closed environment. And they'll tell you, they'll be the first to tell you that. We were welcomed, of course, with open arms, and because we weren't competing with them in that industry. As a matter of fact, we were promoting their industry, so of course they were very nice to us, and I must say they really were great and supportive, and some of them, the people in Lexington are in our film, and couldn't help to have helped us any more than
yeah.
they did. I mean, they were great.
Are you a new sort of devotee of horse racing, or have you always been interested in horses?
Well, I haven't been to very many horse races, but I have quarter horses in Colorado, and I ride a lot in Colorado.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
Jordan and Lindsay, your daughters, do they ride?
We all ride as a family. Sometimes we pack the horses and ride up into the top of the Rocky Mountains and camp out for days.
Do you find that going uphill is much easier than going down? I don't know why I bring this up, but Marianne took me once on a little sort of day trip that would normally take about 10 minutes in a car. It took us 5 hours to get there on horseback. And we went up the hill, which was great, but coming down the other side, there's something about the horse. Let me show you this.
All right.
Something about the horse when you're going downhill that he goes, and you know what that does right in here? And especially, you know, boots, they just don't end right where they're supposed
to. And that saddle horn is
Holy
there.
Holy smokes.
Right at the wrong moment.
You really got to love horses, folks.
I have one really funny story to
yeah.
tell you. My horse, it was a trained cutting horse, so, and he's just very, very
Explain what a cutting horse is.
He cuts cattle. He would go in, cowboys would use this horse, and they would separate cattle and herd cattle. And
they know by instinct how to do it.
And you better hold on,
yeah.
because he knows his business, and you're just sort of along for the ride. But anyway, so we're on this trail one day, and I was, as my usual, talking a mile a minute to my friend, telling some, probably something I shouldn't have been saying. So there was a log tree across the trail, and my horse flew straight up. He walked right up to it and went straight up in the air and over it. Now what happened to me, because I wasn't paying attention, is I flew straight up in the air, and when I came down with the saddle horn back here. So I'm between the saddle and the horse's neck, which is here. My feet are still in the stirrups, which are there. And I have no reins.
Must have looked like a hood ornament.
I did. I don't know what I look like. It was only, and the horse is running, just running as fast as it can.
Well, take a look at this nose. Thanks to a horse.
This is a horse nose?
Yes.
I've had horse kiss.
No, it's not a horse nose. I've had it broken about three times, and once was when a horse, and they're very smart, they seem to be. They know, first of all, they know if you can ride or if you can't ride, the minute you get on them. And they can be very vindictive. And one of the habits is stopping short. And you go forward, and guess where his head goes?
Wing.
Right up and meets you. All right, let's take a look at a clip from Bluegrass.
Great.
And then we'll continue our discussion.
Disqualify him for sure.
After having gelded.
You can't cut him. He'll make a wonderful stud.
Oh. He'll make a wonderful stud eating his opposition.
But you can't geld him.
Miss Breen, I can damn well do whatever I want with whatever I own.
And sell him to me.
Boy.
I'll breed him.
Sure, you'll breed him for his placid personality.
Well, maybe he just hates the track.
He hates the world.
Maybe. Name your price.
I'll give a dollar more than Mrs. Breen offers any time.
$100,000.
Well, I'd say that's a pretty fair price for a fourth-generation outlaw king. I'll make it $125,000.
$200,000.
$225,000.
I want $500,000, a half a million, for that piece of horse flesh.
Sold.
Very nice. You know, it seems like all of the women on Charlie's Angels have continued to do well, and you certainly have done extremely well. I'm going to bring up about three or four films. One was, well, of course, Charlie's Angels. We all know you from that. I guess this is sort of a chronological list.
Right.
Crossings, the Daniel Steele book, Grace Kelly, and then, of course, Deadly Care, which dealt with a nurse that, I guess, got involved with drugs and alcohol.
Yes.
And it was a moving, moving story, and I think did a lot to help the perception, not only on the part of the public, but on the part of hospitals around the country and administrators. Any favorites? And not necessarily out of those three or four.
Oh, golly, every time I'm involved in one, that's my favorite at the moment. I think you have to sort of fall in love with the project to spend that much time and energy.
What project do you feel you've fallen most in love with?
It's so hard to answer this. Maybe The Hasty Heart. Not very many people probably saw it. It was on Showtime, and it was the John Patrick play, and I played an English nurse.
That was a theatrical piece, though,
yes,
that was filmed.
Yes,
yeah,
that was taped. And it was just maybe because of the accent and, and being the only woman with eight men.
All right, stop
there. I sort of liked it.
what about your least favorite?
My least favorite.
You're not being graded on this, realize that.
Oh, good. Do I have to answer this question?
No, there's
no. Oh, good.
There's no grade at the end of this. All right, while you're thinking, talk to me about Child Help, something you're very close to. Very involved.
Well, Child Help USA has been a group that I have worked with for almost 10 years now. And they are working for the prevention of child abuse. And they have done incredible things. I was awarded their Woman of the World Award last year for the work that I have done with them for the last 9 years, which was totally unnecessary. But it was a thrill because it sort of gave me a chance to look back at all the years that I spent there and had a chance to see the children and the progress that has been made with a lot of the children that I got to know when they were very small. And they're just doing amazing things. They have a hotline number to call. They're doing research. They have research programs in colleges all over the
country. We know how important it is for someone like you to be involved in that because it does draw attention. We applaud your efforts, and I'm going to keep after you about your least favorite, all right?
Uh-oh.
Bluegrass, of course, airs on CBS February 28th and 29th. And coming up, we're going to talk about a frightening new discovery in that our nurses who actually make their patients have heart attacks and then save them.